Hey everyone, Kelsey here. Is it me, or has Apple been trying to shake things up this year? First, they got rid of the audio jack in the iPhone 7, then they replaced all the standard laptop ports in favor of Thunderbolt 3, and now they're replacing the function keys with a cool new touch bar. While a lot of these things might take some time to get used to, what does this mean in the long term for the repairability of the MacBook Pro? We've got the 13-inch MacBook Pro with touch bar on our teardown table, and we're ready to find out. As we just opened up the MacBook Pro with function keys last week, we know just how to get into this new Pro. We remove the panel lobes, pop the clips, and lift the lid off with a familiar sliding maneuver. We tackled the trackpad first and are happy to see it can be removed without taking out the logic board. We can also happily report that the trackpads from these respective models are identical and likely cross-compatible. The trackpad has its own set of chips, including the ST Microelectronics ARM Cortex M3 MCU and the Broadcom Touch Controller. In order to remove the battery, the fans, and the speakers, we had to first take out the logic board. Did you notice we hadn't mentioned removing the SSD? Well, here's why. Your flash storage now comes as these SanDisk NAND flash storage chips, meaning replacing or upgrading your SSD is no longer an option. We also find the Intel Core i5 processor with Intel Iris Graphics 550, what is likely the custom Apple T1 chip that pairs with the Touch Bar, and the 8 GB of Samsung-made DDR3 DRAM, which is also soldered to the logic board. To see the complete list of chips we've identified, head on over to the teardown at iFixit.com. We've seen fingerprint scanners on laptops for quite a while, but this is the first time it's been on the MacBook Pro. We pinch off the sapphire crystal plate and take a look at the hardware, consisting of a button coupled with capacitive sensors. Yay for biometrics! Rest in peace, MagSafe, you were a good pal. Next out is one of the two USB-C ports that can handle charging, DisplayPort, Thunderbolt, and USB 3.1 Generation 2. With that port removed, we can finally get to the fans. These fans measure 43 millimeters in diameter, which is slightly smaller than the one we found in the entry-level MacBook Pro, but this model comes with two. Once we remove the fans and pry out the speakers, we're left with this 49.2 watt-hour battery. That's down from the 54.5 watt-hour battery in the function key model. This battery assembly is entirely and very solidly glued into the case, thus complicating replacement. Let's hope these Pro batteries are less excitable than the Note 7s. Lastly, we come to the touch bar, which is solidly glued to the upper case. Breaking out the eye opener, we're about to show you how to break the touch bar. Our efforts to separate the OLED panel from the upper case resulted in the digitizer separating from the display and some slight chipping of the OLED. Our dreams of a repairable touch bar are crushed for now. Hopefully we find a better way to do this in the future. We've come to the end of our teardown, so it's time to reflect on repairability. How did the 13-inch MacBook Pro with touch bar score? It got a 1 out of 10, and here's why. On the upside, the trackpad can be removed without first removing the battery. But on the downside, proprietary panel lobe screws continue to make working on the device unnecessarily difficult. The battery assembly is entirely and very solidly glued into the case, thus complicating replacement. The processor, RAM, and flash memory are soldered to the logic board. The touch bar adds a second difficult-to-replace screen to damage. And finally, the Touch ID sensor doubles as a power switch and is paired with the T1 chip on the logic board. Fixing a broken power switch may require help from Apple or a new logic board. And that's our teardown. For the complete teardown, including tons of beautiful high-quality images, head on over to iFixit.com. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay up to date on the latest teardowns and repair videos. You can follow us on Twitter, @iFixit, and give us a like on Facebook at facebook.com/iFixit.